If my foundation already has an SPF, do I really need a separate sunscreen? Yes. Does that mean the SPF in makeup or moisturizers is worth less than the SPF in a dedicated sunscreen? No. Confused again? I totally get that. So let me explain why the SPF in makeup products is on the one hand absolutely legitimate, but you on the other hand should not rely on it exclusively for your protection. Hi, I'm Dr. Anne. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews, so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. I bet you have something like that in your stash as well, a foundation with SPF. This one claims SPF 40 PA++. Or your day cream claims to have sun protection, and you probably looked at it and wondered if you really need to wear a dedicated sunscreen with it. The answer is yes, but let's look at it in depth. SPF claims in products. Any product, no matter if it's sunscreen, foundation, or day cream, that wants to claim a sun protection factor needs to undergo the same testing. If you do not undergo the testing, you cannot put an SPF claim on your product. That doesn't mean the product has no sun protection. It might as well have all the filters, but as long as it hasn't been tested, you can't say it has SPF. In fact, there are quite a few products, especially in the makeup section, that probably have a certain protection value, but no claims. Why? Because testing is expensive and complicated. That's also the explanation why a foundation might claim an SPF in one country, but not in another. The formulation is the same, but the tests haven't been conducted for that specific country. The bottom line is, when a foundation says it has an SPF of 40, it has an SPF of 40, and that's the same SPF 40 that a sunscreen would have. So yes, the foundation provides SPF 40 if you apply the same amount that was used in testing. As I said in my previous video about how much sunscreen do I need, you will only get the claim protection if you apply the correct amount. And that amount is, as a rule of thumb, 2 mg per centimeter square on your face and neck, which is a lot. I actually measured that out in the video, so you're more than welcome to take a look. If you apply 75% of that amount, you only get half of the proclaimed protection. If you apply half of that amount, the effective protection factor you will get is even lower. So half of SPF 50 will give you an SPF of 10. And that is exactly why you cannot rely on your makeup for adequate protection. No one would ever apply 2 mg per centimeter square of foundation to their face. Well, there are actually some people that did that just to prove how awful that looks, so Google that if you don't believe me. With foundation, you use a few drops. With your moisturizer, you use the least amount you can get away with. After all, you want your skin to feel smooth and hydrated, not suffocated by a thick layer of product. So as long as you don't really cake it on, you will not get effective sun protection and need to wear a dedicated sunscreen, even on cloudy days and even indoors. I hope that answered the very common question that popped up in the comments. I'm going to link to a few more sunscreen videos on the screen that I think you might enjoy, and I'm going to see you all very soon with another one. Bye!